Hello, callers, and welcome back to Viva Bazaar, the home of everything Bazaar. Guys, in this episode, we are going to be discussing the latest update on FC Barcelona as usual. We are going to begin with Edinson Cavani, this Manchester United striker who have been linked with Barca for some time. Recent reports are saying that Xavi have rejected the signing of Edinson Cavani. We are going to be discussing on that report as we move ahead. Then secondly, we are going to be talking about defender Eric Garcia, as it has been reported that Eric Garcia have been told to improve his game in order to avoid the bench. We are going to be discussing on that as well. So guys, as we get ready to discuss those stories in much detail, please make sure to subscribe to the channel if you haven't subscribed. Give this video a like and make sure to watch this video right up to the very end. Barcelona have three pure number nines at the club, yet suffer from a crisis in front of goal. Despite having the services of many forwards, Barca have lacked effectiveness in front of goal. Martin Braithwaite suffered a long-term injury at the beginning of the season. Kun Aguero, who was thought to be the new striker of the club, suffered cardiac arrhythmia and is now staring retirement in the face. Luke de Jong is another option in attack. However, since he signed from Sevilla, de Jong has looked like a fish out of water. Not only has he been ineffective in front of goal, but also disjointed from the rest of the team. Such a profile is not what Xavi Hernandez wants in his team, and that explains why the striker has not played in either of Xavi's two games so far. However, the club are actively looking for options to solidify the striking position. Edinson Cavani is one player who is said to be ready to make the switch to Barcelona. The Uruguayan's role at Manchester United has depleted since the arrival of Cristiano Ronaldo. However, according to a report from El Nacional, Xavi has rejected the possibility of signing Edinson Cavani. The manager feels that Cavani is not an age that would be beneficial to the club. The new coach is only interested in youngsters who have a future ahead of them. It is not surprising to see him reject the signing of Cavani. The striker has played 5 league games for his club this season and has only scored the solitary goal in the Champions League. He is yet to score with 3 appearances already under his belt. Then moving on to the next story of discussion. In just his second match in charge of Barcelona, manager Xavi sprung a surprise by opting to play with a 3-man back line. Indeed, Xavi set up with a 3 at the back system against Benfica on Tuesday night in the UEFA Champions League. While the formation was a surprise, his choice of personnel to form the 3-pronged defensive unit also raised some eyebrows. Xavi held on to senior statesman Gerard Piqué in the side, but opted to draft Ronald Araujo and the out-of-favor Clément Lenglet into the starting 11, leaving Eric Garcia out in the cold. This, as per El Nacional, was a warning for the Spanish defender to improve his game, lest he will, be spending more time on the bench than on the field. Garcia arrived at Barcelona this past summer on a free from Manchester City. A former La Masia prospect, Garcia has not been able to showcase his best performances as of yet at the Camp Nou. Xavi had handed Eric Garcia a start in his first game in charge against Espanyol over the weekend. And why Barcelona were able to secure a clean sheet that night, the club legend is said to have not been entirely impressed by the youngster's display. The report claims that the ex-Manchester City prospect, who is adept at carrying the ball out from the back, was taking his starting berth for granted. But Xavi has acted swiftly to nip any such feelings in the bud by asking him out, for the midweek clash in favor of Araujo and Lenglet. With Piqué a regular fixture, Eric Garcia, Araujo, and Lenglet will be left competing for the other centre-back slots, assuming Xavi returns to his favorite 4-3-3 formation. Based on Tuesday's performance, Araujo has done his chances of becoming a regular no harm, so the onus will now be on Garcia to step up and improve in order to get regular game time. So, callers, with that, we come to an end of this episode. Thanks a lot for watching. Hope you did enjoy the video and also hope you did subscribe. If you haven't, please make sure to do so you always stay in touch with the latest on FC Barcelona here on Viva Barça. Until next time, bye-bye.